afternoon, good night, whenever you're watching this. Welcome. Oh, this is indeed a happy place. Turning off phones. Getting, look, there's notifications just popping off all the time. It kind of can make you crazy. So bringing you to a place of let it all hang out. This is a unique show because it's about you getting in touch with your real, true, deepest self that you keep private and you don't share to other people, maybe a select few. But this is about your inner thoughts, your food for thought that we're gonna give you. Kind of an inner journey, and this is to support that inner journey, maintenance, leveling up, giving you all the goods, golden little nuggets of support, encouragement. I saw a quote last night, and it's one I've seen many times, and it's so true. Be an encourager. There are enough critics in this world already. And that is so true. You can come into contact with a downer, a critic, someone who looks at the cracks, how something is not perfect. But that is a little bit defeating because perfection is an impossibility. So if you're striving for perfection, you'll always be striving for the carrot, always, and you'll never get it. It'll be right out here, right, it'll be out of your reach, out of your touch. And that is like H-E-L-L, maybe? I don't want to be there. That was a golden nugget that was given to me in my master's degree program because I was a perfectionist. And I was unhappy at times because it always just was out of my reach, I felt. It wasn't here. Getting that piece of letting that go and focusing on being as excellent as you can in this moment and developing yourself more and more every day, but being your most authentic self. Be yourself. Who are you? If someone asked you, who are you? You'd probably say, oh, I'm a mechanic, or I'm a coach, I'm an artist, I'm an engineer, business owner, fill in the blank. But no, who are you? How would you describe yourself? What would you say in that moment? There are so many descriptive words. I can't even go into it. That'd be a long, 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 long list. And we're here to get you fueled up, get you powered up. Cheers, Spindrift. I hope you are one of my sponsors one day because I have this every day, maybe one or two. And it's my treat. It's my special thing. And it's healthy, no additives, except for the some that do, a few, but I won't go in there. Cheers to you. And this creation, this life that you are building, which is your greatest masterpiece. I love it. I love it. You, in this lifetime, are the masterpiece. What are you going to do with your blank canvas? Do you dare go after everything that you want? Some people don't even dare. They don't even pick up anything to go after it because they're so fear-based or doubt-based or... And then there's other people that pick it up and they put it back down because the reality of making your dreams come true is that you absolutely have to be in love with it because it can take decades of discipline, hard work, hours and hours and hours toiling away at the mundane. So you have to have passion for it to take you the long haul. That is motivation. Being in love with something, enjoying it. Then you pick it up again and again and again. Okay, what is our card for the day? This is from Gabrielle Bernstein's Super Attractor and Spirit Junkie decks. I mixed them because I wanted a big, fat, abundant pile. That's what this is about, babies. We are taking you to your abundance. We are knocking the scarcity mindset out of the water. It is a mindset. A long time ago, I always was wondering, why are people with seemingly very little happier than most people who have a lot? And it is a process, of course, not an easy answer, but you know, it's a mindset. It's a, what are your values? What's your definition of success? What is your joy? What is your happy? That kind of thing. So fascinating to get to that place in your life where you see the cup as half full and gratitude and what you have and abundance, and instead of looking at what you don't have and a lack of inner peace. I mean, just being grateful. This little lavender sachet I found in Makawao at a wonderful store. And peace, inner peace. This is a revolutionary show, I hope, to awaken minds, to break open the gold that you're seeking in life. It can come in many ways that you wouldn't even think. So I hope you stumble upon this. I hope you go, oh my gosh, this is what I've been looking for. Holistic wellness, potency tips, taking care, TLC tips. It's really where it's at. You get your fill, you get your fuel, and you blast off. If you don't have fuel, good luck blasting off. You'll be lucky to push yourself off. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. Okay. This is today. I consciously choose to think loving thoughts, take compassionate actions, and bring forth peaceful energy. This class is also about reminders just of where to put our energy, which is like a seed, and we put energy towards it and it nurtures and grows and we water it. Attention on something is watering something. So we can only give what we have. So what about the people that don't water, don't give attention to the people in their life? They're just very self-focused, or, you know, it's all about them. Well, your relationships are going to be pretty poopy, dead. And maybe there's some work that needs to be done on that. And there's no shame about it. It's just, oh, okay, yes, I have to work on that. And I love myself enough to know that it's not an inherent biological thing. It's something that I can nurture and work on and change, how to change. So lots of good ingredients to help you in how to change. So here's another one that I picked yesterday I wanted to share with you. My super attractor power comes from how I feel, my faith in love, and the joy I put out. So, are you magnetic? Can you say that? I am magnetic. Do you feel that that's true? Can you take that in? Can you embody it? Can you be it? Or is there doubt? Maybe you haven't accessed this level fully. That's okay. That's what we're here for, to help you level up, help you access the VIP backstage behind the curtain pile of gold. Okay, what next? Let's see, I really like these because they give you food for thought. Our intellectual boost. Most of this is for your mindset, but once you boost your mindset, it is a ripple effect, and then you want to take care of yourself better, eat better, you feel better, you're more productive. It's all connected. Optimism is an intellectual choice. Again, is your cup half empty, half full? It's a choice. Choice to be grateful, choice to be ungrateful. Hey, one more. The next time your mind wanders, follow it around for a while. So this is the importance of exploring, experimenting, letting yourself play, letting yourself be free, unchained. Even if you have to do it in the privacy of your own home, let yourself be wild for a minute. Oh, can you hear the dog whining? Always having to take care of something. That's what we do. People come for the goods. Take care of me. I want some. Hold on. So we're back. I'm back. We're all back. I'm going to put on some music, which I wanted to anyway, because the dog shuffles back and forth. And you can hear him. Oh, shoot. I lost the card. Oh, well. It's okay. We got it on camera. Okay. Ooh, I like this one. This is Goal Crusher. Does it have it on? Crush your goals. What are your goals? What do you want in this life? What do you want to accomplish? As a coach, it's yes, taking the big vision. Got that. Check. And breaking it down into baby steps of where to start first. And then doing them. Oh, oh my gosh! This is one of my most favorites, and I have used it, quoted it all the time because, oh my gosh, I always say that it takes a village. If you want to get somewhere and you have little support, oh my gosh, that road is going to be long and harder than most. That's why try to find support, try to find your tribe, try to find the people that are similar to you. I always say fire attracts fire, right? Zest attracts zest. Harmony, meeting people like ourselves is so harmonious. It just feels good and it flows. And not a lot of conflict, but ability to handle the conflict and move on without an explosive something that happens that is damage producing. Okay. Be strong, be fearless, be beautiful, and believe that anything is possible when you have the right people there to support you. Misty Copeland. When I saw this one a year or two ago, when my sister gave it to me, this deck, I got this card and I was like, oh my gosh, that is so true. Anyone who is in power, is in a power position, entertainment, CEOs, just anybody who has made it somewhere in life, got there with the right support, got there with the people in their corner, helping them win. You know, there's the dark side of people in power too, but I'm talking about the people that are on the right side of the law, that are trying to do good, trying to make a difference in the world, versus just having power, power hungry, money hungry, that kind of people, right? Avoid. No VIP access here. So it's just, it's fabulous. It's like, okay, relax, keep working, and have find people that are going to be on your A team. Who's on your A team? I only have a handful that I trust, and I'm still seeking the support team in some areas. Sometimes it takes time to attract your A team, but keep praying. Keep thanking the Lord. Thank the Lord every single day. Thank you for helping me. Thank you for leading me to where I need to go. This is quite the ride that we're on, and navigating it successfully is asking for all support to come in and help you. Physically, the people around you, but also a spiritual connection. I have not been able to do this ride without the Lord. Oh my gosh. Crazy. When you're in your lane, there's no traffic. Ava DuVernay. Unique, baby. Be unique. Do your own thing. Love yourself. Shine. I'm not a cookie cutter sheep. It may be a little bit more challenging to be authentic, but I would prefer it this way. Gotta prefer it. Because this is living alive, living electric, believing in your creation, going after your dreams, wearing the pink tutu because you love it. At a performance with an unapologetic air. Wild, free, vital, potent. Yeah, baby. Okay, what's next? This is so fun. I hope you're having fun and you're getting a daily dose of relaxed feelings, upliftment, intellectual stimulation, entertainment, theatrical, alive. Perfection has been kicked to the curb and we're here going, going with the moment, improv. Who here is good at improv? Improv is a mastery level where you are so good at what you're doing that you can create in the moment. A leader, knowing where you're going versus a question mark. Do I know what I'm doing? Versus, I know what I'm doing. Come with me, you're in good hands. This song is beautiful. Memories, Rum Sephiros, absolutely talented. Things are looking up. Write something you want to affirm about yourself or something you want to be as if it already exists. Read the sentence aloud to yourself. Feel it and believe it. So this is, yeah, affirm something about yourself. Say, I am a conductor of magnetism. I am a powerful attractor. I am positive. I am beautiful. I am fill in the blank, right? And then something you want to be as if it already exists. I am Master Lego. Lego Master. Isn't that a show? But what? What makes your heart just burst open? You're so in love with that activity. And I'm not talking about another person. I'm talking about some activity, something that you have the control over doing. Is it rock climbing, surfing, running, dancing, art, your happy place? Absolutely, your happy place. Because it feels so good. Read this sentence aloud to yourself 100 times, 1,000 times, 1,000,000 times. Feel it. Believe it. You are the creator. Do you believe it? That's the power of beliefs. That's the power that beliefs have. If you believe it, it manifests. If there's a question mark because you're full of doubt, that isn't the conductor for making things happen. Confidence, assurance. I let an inner sense of quiet multiply each day as I strengthen my faith in the love of the universe. So again, feeling supported. Do you feel supported? Take a minute. Do you feel that your family supports you, your friends, the people around you? Maybe you do have support on the continuum of a little or a lot. When you know you're supported by the Lord, the universe, your higher power, it's a calm, a knowing, asking for assistance or support during the times when you're not sure, because sometimes we get hit by buses of difficulty. So I let an inner sense of quiet multiply each day, because that is one of the things that we're going after. The inner quiet, zen, inner zen. Where does that stem? How is that created? Strengthening my faith. Relaxing, deep calm, so your nervous system can regenerate versus being on all the time. And then that constant that happens wears down your body in other ways. Again, I'm not a medical doctor. I'm just a wellness specialist with a master's degree in marriage and family therapy. So knowing relationships and what they do to us and how they affect us for good or not so good. The importance of who you allow around you affects your overall well-being, health, vitality. So everything, these suggestions that I bring up are just suggestions. And it's with an entertaining flair. But you are the ultimate decision maker of what's for your life. So this is geared to 18 and older. who can start, you know, making their own decisions and what they want for their lives. I'm Coach. I'm your coach, coaching you to greatness. And you're simply fabulous, darling. Spiritually, every person on this planet is fabulous. I'm not blowing smoke up your skirt or your pants or whatever. But you're here, everyone here has something to offer the world, has something to bring the world. Figuring out what that is and sharing it is where it's at. You know your purpose. This show is also to help you find your purpose, your meaning, your passion, your substance, your not milk toast here. We're a little bit intense. We're determined, we're moving, going, building, creating. This class, this time, the show is for everyone, yes. And it's for people that take the responsibility, know that they creating their lives is in their hands. They can sit there and watch and wait, and it might never happen. Or you get up and you go, oh, I'm gonna be sloppy and messy and make tons of mistakes, but I'm willing to take that step, that journey, because here is kind of sad, dark, waiting, no movement, purgatory, limbo. I mean, there's all different words for it. And preferably to be one who takes their bravery and makes things happen, has the faith and hope that it can happen, that it's possible. And it's the success stories of who has come before you, who has been successful in the journey from the transformation from dark to light, or broken to healed, or, you know, some people have a great upbringing, a great life, and then other people, they don't get the support, the love, the guidance, the encouragement that they need, because maybe one of their parents was MIA or was unable to show love, or and maybe there was a death in the family or divorce, or and so you something's missing. You don't have that. It went away. It is missing. So that's the journey of reclaiming, coming back to maybe reclaiming that piece that left, that's waiting for it to come back. I know this is deep stuff. Okay, let's keep on going. Oh my gosh, such a dive deep. And that's what you get here with the daily dose. We're not going in superficial 3 feet waters. We might, yes, for a moment. But what really satisfies is going deep, going in to the source, being unafraid, being fearless, going, getting the information. To utilize it for thyself. Tons of people, books, everything. People I've come into contact with, a nugget of information, a nugget. Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh, that was a piece of the puzzle. Because I use the analogy of a disco ball a lot, is when you've had difficult things happen in your life that are traumatic, you're burst into so many pieces, and sometimes it takes years to get all the little pieces back and put it together with the glue, and it comes together into a magnificent disco ball. So this process is taking you from where you are and making you even more amazing. The 2.0 version, the bettered up version. Okay, you are inspiring. Stay on your journey. Transformation, how to. You're gonna be inspiring people that it can be done. No more question marks. I don't know if I can heal. I don't know if I can activate. I don't know if I can awaken. I don't know. Yes, you can. It has happened before you, with you, and after you, because you're gonna share what you've gained with other people. And it's this absolutely awesome, positive, well, contagion, but spreading. And you're doing a great job. You're putting forth the effort. I keep burying the cards. Oh, well. Okay, what are we gonna do? Goals, gratitude, self-care. So by chance, what are the cards that you need to focus on today? We are high maintenance because we're operating at a high level. A lot goes into this. So these are just reminders. Did you take care of your fill in the blank today? Did you take a break? Did you take a break? Every day, try to take a break where you go somewhere quiet, you sit, you close your eyes, maybe you put some instrumental music, here again, Simple Things by Sapphiros, and go to your deep, calm place where everyone has, they don't have access, right? It's only you. Even if it's 5 minutes. I got this one the other day. I wanted to share it with you. Take more chances. Being a risk taker, holy moly. That takes a lot. You have to go out on a limb. Sometimes there's nobody else there. And you're like, holy shit! Oops. Oh, that's why this is for 18 and older. I do swear, not very often, but that's the real deal. Intense. We're not sugarcoating it here. Okay, either move or be moved. This was the one I saw the other day. Either take care of yourself or you will be brought to your attention that you need to take care of yourself. The other thing is either move or be moved. Take more chances. Move it. Make it happen. What do you want? You have to make the moves in order for it to happen. It's not going to just come to you, fall in your lap. Hi, I'm here. No, you need to seek it. Carve it out. What do you want? And it's like being so clear about what you want that it's so strong and you're determined. And it is. It's like carving something out of stone, marble. No, it will be. Oh, it will be. If you're on the good side and trying to do something good in the world and you were given this dream, you are also given what you need in order to make it happen. You just have to carve it out. Believe in it 100% that it is possible. And no matter what anybody else says, and if you really want it, you work at it every single day. Want to be a ballet dancer? Do it. There is going to be a lot of information that comes to you that makes you say, do you really want to be a ballet dancer? Because there's a lot that goes into being a good ballet dancer. And it's the same with fill in the blank, ballet dancer, fill in the blank. Whatever you want to go after and be is going to take a crap load of work. You better love it. Oh my gosh, we got it again. Set a positive intention for the day. What value do you want to focus on today? Again, we're back. This was in the first episode. What do you value? What's important to you? That is going to mold your life. It's going to dictate your life. It's interesting. It came up. That's really interesting. So I want to focus on watering my relationships today. And I'm going to call my best friends, my family, and just send them love. Unless they're abusive, you know, and you're not safe, of course. Do not do that. But I'm talking, maybe you can just send them love in your mind. Sometimes, I mean, I send people love all the time that I haven't talked to in years because I wish them well. They were a wonderful person, but I'm not in touch with them anymore because they didn't stay in touch or they went their other way. I try to stay in touch with people. I give them a chance to stay in touch, and then if there's not 50% in a relationship where reciprocation, give and take, I let go and I say, you know what? I don't deserve crumbs. If you're not going to be there 50%, then it's okay because you're not meant to be in my life. You don't get the VIP tickets anymore. You got to take care to get that ticket. Listen to music for 5 minutes without doing anything else. Jeez Louise, I think we got this one too. I'm gonna take one more. Again, calming the nervous system, taking care of yourself, beautifying your moment. What power do you have in this moment that you have control over? Not everything else that's going wackadoodle and crap show in your life. What do you have control over in this moment? Listen to 5 minutes of music without doing anything else. Beautify your life so you can tap that mine of gold and beauty that is going to be replenishing you on the daily. That's why this is the daily dose, to try to educate, inspire, motivate of the work that you need to do, developing new habits that will take you the long haul, that's going to fuel you, take you to the stars, soar. And I do. I want you guys to sing and dance. Have a little fun. Get down tonight. Take an unusual route and notice what looks different. Ooh, again, into the experimentation, the newness, the new experience. When things get dull and dry and mundane, and I've done that before, and nothing exciting is here to stimulate, it's, oh my gosh, how can I stimulate? How can I do something about this blech? Shake it up, do something different. I love that reminder. Okay, radiant harmony, positive affirmations card. What do you need today? These two are jumping out. Oh, three. Helpfulness. I embody helpfulness by serving others with compassion and kindness, spreading positivity, and making a meaningful impact on the world. Very nice. I believe when we get to a stage in our lives, our cup is full and we want to help others. So serving others, taking care of others, it really does make for a more meaningful life. And positive. I embrace mastery. I embrace the journey of mastery, knowing that it requires patience and perseverance. So this goes back into becoming excellent at what you want to do, attaining your dreams. It is a level of mastery that is required, and it takes a crap load of work. Crap. So, massive amount of patience, perseverance, over and over and over and over again. But if you love it, okay. Instead of, oh my gosh. Acceptance. I honor and accept myself with love and compassion. Being at a Zen space in your life absolutely requires self-acceptance. Acceptance of others, because once you accept yourself, you can accept others. You give what you have. So radical self-acceptance, unconditional love. You ask yourself, am I unconditionally loving to people? Am I unconditionally loving to myself? If this happened, would I still love myself? This happened. Do I still love myself? And to other people too. They're not perfect. You're not perfect. No one's perfect. Appreciation then stems out of acceptance, is appreciating people for what they do bring, what they are. Okay, I always think I'm going to do a really quick reading, and then this is fun. I love being here. I hope that you do too. I hope that you're getting some really good positive boost. I'm looking over, this song is called Until We Meet Again, Peak Twilight and Ames. Amy's? This is really good, just to turn on some instrumental music, finding that artist that does it for you. Oh my gosh, I mean, I started using music when I was, 16 to get through the hard times, 16, 17, because I felt like I had nobody. I mean, I'm the inner sanctum. Inner sanctuary, I was very alone. It was a very hard time in my life, but I survived. Maybe you can relate. Gaining strength, support, love. This ride is not always just sunshine and butterflies. It's really, really, really hard. And where do you go for good loving when the chips are down and no one's around and you're going through something really hard? Again, creating the environment that promotes growth, blooming, being at your best. That's why you're here. That's why you're still watching, because this resonates to a core part of you. Where it's like, yes, I get it. I'm living it. I'm trying to transform my life. I'm trying to get free of maybe an addiction, or trying to get that job that you want. There's many different people that come to listen, get the information. There's some goods in here, I promise you. There is no such thing in anyone's life as an unimportant day. I can agree with that, because every day we learn something, we get a little piece of the puzzle of the disco ball. Learning and growing daily, absolutely. Okay, I think we're gonna close with this. Morning affirmations, 200 phrases for an intentional and open-hearted start to your day. Again, intentional. This is intentionalizing your life. What do you want to build on? And then how do you get the pieces that you need, the baby steps, in order to make it a reality? There can be 100 baby steps, 100 habits to implement. So stay tuned, because every time we do one of these shows, it's going to hit on a different tangent, a different idea, a different piece of the puzzle, brick in your house. You're a brick house. Okay, I seek validation from my own heart. I reaffirm my heart's brilliance, shining unclouded by anyone else's judgment. I feel the difference between proving myself to others and doing what is best for me. When it comes to outside opinions and requests, I answer yes only when my heart says yes. So, this is huge. This is about when you're in your own lane, there's no traffic. When you are fully independent, you no longer seek validation outside of yourself. You go to yourself, your center, because you know the best about who you are, what you're doing, what's your intention, what's your meaning, what's your purpose, your why, right? So why are you doing what you're doing? Recognizing it, looking at it, being real, dissecting it, being a detective, getting information from the inside first. Joanna Keller, a wise woman I saw when I was around 16, 18, something like that, she said, it's an inside job, recognition. Don't look for it on the outside. It'll never come that way. And happiness, joy is an inside job too. And it took me a while to figure out how to manufacture my own sunshine. Let's see, I wanna do this one too. And then we're out. I can control what I focus on, so I focus on what I can control. I strengthen the feelings that I want to last. I tell myself only things that I want to come true. Life elevates what I pay attention to. I pay attention to what I want to grow. Absolutely. We hit on this earlier. What do people put their attention to? That is what is going to grow in your life. If it's worry, doubt, fear, that's going to grow. If you want peace, positivity, cooperation, collaboration, growth, prosperity, abundance, intellectual stimulation, I mean, all those things, it's going to grow. If you're paying attention to your healing, your activation, getting the knowledge, you will grow. It will happen. So keep going, keep at it, and tell yourself only the things that you want to come true. You are giving life to what you focus on, what you pay attention to. So there's power in that. What do you want to grow in your life? Ask yourself that. Become aware of what your thoughts are on a daily basis. Are they positive? Are they negative? Are they helping you? Are they keeping you down? How can you break free and move it to a positive place? Sometimes things come in to help us strengthen to make what we want happen. Again, being here now, loving the moment, loving yourself, and then going from here. It's just this huge, bigger picture and all the tiny little pieces that have to go in to make that big picture a reality. It's a lot of work, but it's totally worth it. Your journey that you are on is going to take you to your masterpiece, the best you, the best version of you, the strongest, most potent, most go-getter, unapologetic, not asking for permission. It will happen because your energy and attention is going to what you want. So, okay, I hope that fueled you up and balanced you in a way of bringing you to what's really important in the moment so you can be at your best, keeping these ideas operating where you can give something. And one last thing is these little journals. This is an idea that you can do, is beautify a journal, workbook. And I have a few for sale on flourishcenterhawaii.com. And I write sayings, and so this is by chance opening it up. And what is the message for you today? So expansion, expanding, taking up more space, going after what you want, not being scared, but opening up and leaping, making what you want happen, but believing in yourself takes expansion. I'm taking up this space. I'm going to do it. Good, fabulous, expansion. What a great word to end on. Okay, take care of you. See you soon. I'm trying to do these as much as I can. You can make a donation at flourishcenterhawaii.com up in the right-hand corner of the website. There is a donate here button, and it'll take you to PayPal. It's legit. We are a nonprofit. And the more donations that come in, the more that we can do these daily doses. It's a win-win. There's only one of me until this grows, and then I can get other people on board too. There's another coach that is working with business clients right now that is on board at Flourish, and an assistant. So we're building, we're growing, but right now we're looking to expand, right? So hopefully you're getting something awesome out of it. And even if you can donate a dollar, $2, $3, $4, $5, $20, $50, $100 is so, I'm just so grateful for the people that have donated, because it does ensure that Supernova Wellness dance classes, total body mind classes get made. This new daily dose that I think is going to be fantastic to fuel you, get you powered up, taken care of. And then the creative expression classes are expanding too. And pray, thank, I thank for the positivity boost music into schools comes about. We already did one concert and it was a huge success. So we're looking forward to bringing music, feel good music, the importance and the essentialness of creativity into the schools or to young kids, so they know that it's always available to them during the good times and the not so good times to get through adversity and difficulty. Exercise, creativity, things boosting your happy chemicals in your own body. These are really important things for everyone on this planet to know, not just kids, but it's a starting point.
what's left is right. Chasing stars and holding you. I can't see the end, but we'll see it through.